The findings are harsh. There's a high level of cruelty in this war in South Sudan, and what we found was that there were deliberate targeting of civilians in villages around these areas, with killings documented, indiscriminate shelling of areas where civilians were found, deliberate killings of civilians, including the elderly or disabled. Also, a lot of rapes and gang rapes of women and children. In this report, the responsibility of the government forces is very high. The events took place in the context of attacks between the SPLA-IO, the opposition, and government forces, but a majority of the violations that were documented were the responsibility of the SPLA and proxy youth gangs that they have used against civilians in many of these villages. This report documents violations, some of which could amount to crimes against humanity and war crimes. A court of law would have to determine what these crimes are, but of course we have documented targeted killings of civilians, including the most vulnerable, and rapes and gang rapes, all of which would qualify as crimes under international law. And the civilian population find themselves absolutely destitute. I mean, there are testimonies that are collected in this report, such as of a 14-year-old girl who really says, how will she ever forget the smell of the burning bodies in her village, or the images of women hanging from trees, as some were reportedly hung from trees after being raped. The main recommendation is to hold the perpetrators to account. The government of South Sudan has in principle agreed to the establishment of a hybrid court for these crimes, and we hope that with the support of the African Union, who is charged with setting up this court, that prosecutions can start, but the government itself can prosecute these crimes and make sure that perpetrators do not continue to commit such crimes in impunity in South Sudan.